They're set. The two-year-olds ready to explode, off racing. And the favourite, Glasgow Lass, amongst the first to go. Harry the Prince, Take Your Chances, showing speed from toward the inside. Pushing up as well, Southern Scandal soon after. Right behind them, Big Shots. A length and a half away to Glasgow Lass. Over on the inside, next of all, is Roxham. It settles down in front of its favourite, who's next, Buster's Girl. A length and a half behind them, Point of Conflict, North Face. They've got the pace really ramped right up. Well back to Brazen Bit, Extra Zero. And the tail end is Elite Missile. They come toward the 500 metre mark, and flying along the newcomer, Take Your Chances, a length and a half, Harry the Prince, just holding for the moment. Southern Scandal in a bit of a pocket coming into the straight. Around them goes Big Shots, and Glasgow Lass is peeling to the outside, beginning to run on as well, hitting the lead, Big Shots, by the 200 mark. But here comes Glasgow Lass, and Glasgow Lass and Big Shots are coming away to fight it out, but Glasgow Lass is going by far, far the better. Glasgow Lass draws clear. An impressive debut. Glasgow Lass pricked the ears up and scored by a length and a half, Big Shots. Third home was Buster's Girl, and Brazen Bid from a day back, and also right behind those, one to follow is Elite Missile. It's made up a stack of ground. They were followed by Roxham, Point of Conflict, followed home then by Extra Zero. Southern Scandal and North Face are well back. Followed home then by Take Your Chances, who really folded up. Geez, it coiled from the corner, and back with it as well as Harry the Prince. Glasgow Lass too good. Lucy Fiore. Smart, precocious style of a filly. The daughter of Alabama Express has put them away to win very well here on debut in the Magic Millions plate over Big Shots, Chris Parnham. A couple of good runs behind them, they will touch upon soon. And Buster's Girl picking up third. Fourth is One Brazen Bid. Huge performance from where it was, and so's Elite Missile. The interim numbers are 10, 2, 9 and 1. 10, 2, 9 and 1. But as sharp as you'll see here for a debutante filly, Glasgow Girl, she's run 104.39. Home in 34.80 and won by two lengths. And although tested there, she did prick her ears late, and she got away from them and dominated in the final stages. Two lengths by 2 3/4. Raced by Justin Warwick, V, Mrs. P, Galati, the Bring Bigger Bags Syndicate. They may well have to. Along also with Linda Britton and G. Pearson, prepared by Mitchell Pateman. And clearly he has a very nice two-year-old filly on his hands with Lucy Fiore in the saddle. Big Shots, Chris Parnham for Luke Fernie by Sizzling from Pintupi. Owned by Luke Fernie, K. Doak and Maria Manfredini. And third, Buster's Girl, which is by I'm All the Talk out of Machino, Miss David, Jenny Harrison, L. Wen, Miss K. Thompson, B. Byrne, N. Mrs. M. L. Shaw, A. Oreb, and also R. Young, the owners there, in the art of Dave Harrison, Jason Whiting, the rider, and then in fourth placing. And it was a big run. Brazen Bid, who'd won at its debut. It made up an absolute mile on them, and so did Elite Missile further back in the field. It's one that's going to come on considerably, the way that it worked to the line, looking for a lot further than 1,100 at least. Race number two, this is the Ray Posse Memorial Plate over 1,200 metres. Jordan Turner's on number six. See you at the session. The late change is for All Play, Joe as a Party. Joey as a Party onto four with Paul Harvey out of action. Not riding here at Ascot this afternoon. Let's go down now to the yard. We'll catch up with Lockie Taylor. She had schooled terrifically in the barrier trials that we've seen of her, and she's brought that straight to Ascot for a first run.
She certainly did, Darren. I'm now joined by winning trainer and Mitch Pateman. Mitch, at filly on debut, clearly set tongues wagging after the Larkhill trial, beating a star two-year-old in Golden Vale. At what point did you tell Justin, did you know you had a serious filly on your hands?
Yeah, very lucky. Justin sent me three two-year-olds at the start of the season, and they all progressed along well, but the further they went, this one sort of just took off from the rest. And yeah, she's been a proper horse ever since she started galloping. She's a beautiful filly to look at. And, yeah, very pleased that she got the job done on debut.
Coming into today, she had an awkward draw to overcome. How did you see the race unfold in your eyes?
Well, I tried to give Lucy 100 instructions yesterday, and we cooked it. So I just said, leave it to you today. Well, Justin told me, leave it to Lucy today, and that's why you leave it to her. That was 12 out of 10, barrier 10, one out, three back in a beautiful rhythm. Once she landed there, I thought it's going to take something pretty special to hold her out.
Today was over 1,100 metres. Now, she's not a Magic Millions purchase, so she won't head to that feature at Pinjarra in 3 weeks' time. I suspect she is going to be aimed up at the autumn features. How do you now plot a path towards the Karrakatta?
Yeah, she'll have 3 weeks off now, and then she'll come back and just race through the natural lead-ups to the Karrakatta. I think she'll come back better again next prep. You know, Justin's handled her really well so far. He's sort of doing it a bit of a different way to what I've sort of seen before, but it seems to be really working.
Well done here.
Thanks, mate.
There's Mitch Pateman. Terrific training performance with the debutante Glasgow Lass. And I think ride of the day is all wrapped up, Michael, with that outstanding steer from Lucy Fiori.
Absolutely. Only one race down, but it'll be hard to beat that one, Luce. Barrier 10 or barrier 9 after scratchings. Looked a little bit awkward on paper, but she looks pretty push button, this filly, and a great ride.
Yeah, thank you. She is actually very professional, so it makes the job really easy. She just kind of did whatever I asked. I'd said to Mitch and Dad before the race, what do we want to do? And they told us, leave it to you. And I was like, okay, we'll just wing it. Yeah, and it all just opened up beautifully. And she was really tractable, come in, relaxed, and then track that horse up and let down. And she really switched off in the end.
Yeah, absolutely. When she straightened up as well, it looks like she really knuckled down and she put them away in a matter of strides in the end.
Yeah, she did. And I think if there was a horse there, that went with her, you would have seen more as well.
She jumped pretty good out of the gates in a race with less speed. Do you think she's a type that could take up a forward position, or she's better with a bunny to chase, even though it's probably a hard question to answer?
At this stage, she's giving me the feeling like she's pretty versatile. Yet to see, but yeah, she jumps and puts herself there, so I don't see why not.
Nice start to the day. Well done.
Thank you.
There's Lucy Fiori combining with Mitchell Pateman and Glasgow Lass in the colours of her father, the great Justin Warwick, to take out the Magic Millions plate on debut.